this amazing program back in April. Have you gotten the response that you wanted from the audience?
In terms of the Redemptive Project. So look, I've never seen anything like the Redemption Project. 99% positive response on Twitter. Twitter, which is usually like hater, right? I mean, Twitter is like where everybody gets trashed. 99% positive response. I think it's because, you know, this is not reality TV. This is not, you know, trying to sensationalize it. This is real people who really had pain in the past trying to sit down and have a conversation. And it's so human. Everybody has done something they regret. Everybody has had something done to them that they didn't like. How do you apologize? How do you forgive? And so it's very, very deep in terms of the stakes for people in the show, but it's being very, very well received.
Was there a particular story that stood out of all of the, because you shot 8 episodes, right?
You know, for me, the episode that we did in Oakland, California with Donald Lacey, I was in the Bay Area when Donald Lacey's daughter, who was like an honor student, totally innocent kid, got gunned down in basically a drive-by shooting. And and it shocked the city. And there were protests for weeks and weeks, and it really was just a turning point moment for Oakland. And I marched in those marches behind her father, you know, and 20 years later to walk into the prison with Donald Lacey, to sit down with the young man who was convicted of that crime, and to see them have a conversation, it was unbelievable. And the twists and turns in that conversation, the surprises, the stuff that you didn't know, the stuff that he didn't know, the stuff that's just, I mean, and you realize when we draw that separation from each other after painful events, healing isn't really possible because you don't have all the facts. You really don't know what happened. So,
thank you so much.
Anyway, well, thank you. Yeah. Hey, so listen, but I want people who are listening to this, Sundays, 9 p.m., CNN. That's Anthony Bourdain's old slot. So you know that's sacred ground for CNN. But it's a powerful show. It's a heartbreak to hope show. It starts off sad. Everybody goes, oh, I don't want to be sad. Stick with the show. It gets good at the end. But you got to get through the breakdown and get through the breakthrough.
All right, so we're talking to Ms. Angela Stanton King of the American King Foundation. So why was it so important for you to kind of partner with our good friend Van Jones here and the Redemption Project?
For me, it's really heartfelt because I know what it feels like to be locked in that cage. A lot of people may know my story when I wrote my first book, Life of a Real Housewife. And it basically kind of details my life of how I ended up in prison, ended up spending some time in prison, giving birth to my daughter, handcuffed to a bed, losing my mother and my grandmother to incarceration, and then coming home and having to build myself up. So once I got out, I started my own nonprofit organization to help returning citizens. And just along that path, I ended up getting connected with Van, helping pass the First Step Act. We worked very hard together on criminal justice reform. And why not partner with him to bring something like this here to Atlanta? Not only is it needed, but the community, we need to know how to heal, and we also need to know how to accept our returning citizens when they come back into the community.
Congratulations, and thanks so much for bringing this here.
Thank you.
We're talking to actor extraordinaire T.C. Carson. T.C., why is it important for you to be here today? We're talking about restorative justice. We're looking at an amazing series, The Redemption Project, featuring Van Jones. So why was it important for you to come out today?
Because we don't get to hear the stories of the people that are incarcerated. Sometimes they have remorse for what they've done. They want to talk to the victims that they've harmed. So this is a way that they can do that. And there's so many of us in jail that it gives us a chance to talk.
Have you had an opportunity to see the series?
No, I haven't.
No?
Not yet.
So what are you looking forward to, I guess, seeing in this particular episode tonight?
I'm open because I don't know. I don't know what it's going to be. So I'm open to see what it's going to be for me.
So what do you say to those that say that we sort of live in a culture now of unforgiveness? We live in a culture of cutting people off. We live in a culture of outing people, that whole thing. How do you feel that this particular show will be able to kind of help us move beyond that?
Well, hopefully we can get back to love and respect. Hopefully we can get back to forgiveness. Right now we have a culture in this country that is really hard. It's really negative. The leader of our country is negative. He's So we have to remember what love is. We have to remember what forgiveness is. We have to remember why we are here. And we're not here to fight, we're here to love. So hopefully this series will give people that have had the trauma, it'll give them an opportunity to think about it and maybe heal themselves.
All right, so we're talking to gospel icon, Mr. Ricky Dillard. We're talking about redemption tonight. So I know that's a real important story for you because you sing about it.
Absolutely.
Every day, each day in your songs. Absolutely. So why was it important for you to be here tonight?
The funny part about this whole night is because I ran across the show already on CNN. Okay. And the episode that I saw was a young black brother who had killed a young black girl, and the father was a community activist for youth, and I was engaged because we don't see those types of things happen, especially between men. And for the father to be able to face the brother who killed his daughter was, and then for the brother who did the killing, the coming together of redemption and forgiveness and to squash it and to forgive, that blessed my heart. And when I heard about tonight, I said, I have to come. That's what my whole ministry is about, redeemed, being refreshed, revived, brought back. And tonight is going to be one of those nights that we get a chance to see in another reality form, that this is still possible on the earth today.
So we're talking to the iconic Mr. Martin Luther King III. How are you?
I'm well, and yourself?
I'm good. So why was it important to have this particular conversation with Van Jones here at the King Center today?
Well, first of all, anytime we think about criminal justice reform and the work that Van Jones and others have done, but certainly his leadership was so significant in the most recent bill that the president signed, and that's just to start. While there are X number of offenders in the federal prisons, the majority of prisoners are obviously in state and local prisons. And so when you think about Georgia, a state with 28-29% African Americans, tragically, the criminal the population percentage wise is probably 75-80% African Americans. We only make up, you know, as I said, less than 30% of the population. How are we 70-80% of the jail population? So my point is, what I think Van Jones and others are doing are helping to bring new legislation that will assist us in restorative rights ultimately, because when you paid your debt to society, your rights should be restored, and that's not always the case. And people should give you opportunities, and that's not always the case. So I think all of these efforts are so significant, and I am really thankful that Van Jones would come to the King Center Historic District. This is an issue that obviously my dad would have been focused on, my mom throughout her life focused on, so it's not a new issue. And certainly it's something, as my sister, CEO of the King Center, and of course, we're all very interested.
All right. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
All right.